What's up, YouTube? I'm back in the still standing garage and I'm working on the 83 Regal again. I'm removing the hydraulic cylinders because they are leaking really bad. I already removed the driver's side over there and decided, you know what, let me make a video out of this. You see, this one's already removed, busting my knuckle removing the hose, but we're going to remove the passenger side over here and I'm going to record the whole process. The reason I'm replacing them is because the other day I drove it pretty locked up, and when I got it home there was a puddle of oil under both sides, so I decided, you know what, let me replace them or rebuild them. I'll probably still rebuild them, but I am gonna buy some new ones because this whole system is from 2005. So you can see that right there. It's all nasty, but the nastiness is not my worries right now. It's the leaking oil. I wanna be able to drive it without a problem. Come on. Ah, here we go. Got a nice and loose. There it is. We'll put this little contraption here, the rag with the zip tie over, because as I'm messing around with it down there, I don't want oil to be splashing everywhere up here. I'll remove it from down there when I'm ready to remove the cylinder. Let's go. So first things first is supporting the bottom A-arm, because I am removing the nut that holds the spindle to the A-arm. Since I'm already here, I do have brand new ball joints, so I'm gonna replace those too. But right now, my concern is those cylinders, like I said. Let's get those out. And that ball joint nut is a 19 millimeter. I already removed the cotter pin that goes in there. So let's pop this one out. If I mess up that boot, I don't care, because like I said, I'm replacing it. Let's lower that arm. Don't want to let it hang too much. All right, look how nasty these are. I do want to replace these coils too, but that's later on. I mean, I don't want it to leak right now. Everything needs to be updated, but it's all good. I have no problem with the way that it's running right now, except for the cylinder's leaking. Let's get this A-arm out of there. If I lift the cylinder from up here, and try to hold it up. Let's see how we could do this. There's that. Let's remove this nastiness. Look how busted these are. I don't even know how many tons these are. Set it off to the side. Watch the fingers. Let's see if we can get it out of there without lowering it anymore. Nope, it's out of there. Put it off to the side right here and we'll take a look at it. All right, another thing that I want to record and I want to show you guys too is the pockets. I want to see how my pockets are. I'm recording this for myself and also to give you guys a view of what it looks like down there. So I am going to flip the camera upside down. Let's see what kind of view we get from down there. Let's go. Hopefully it's doing good. I do want to reinforce these pockets later on. I want to see how they're doing right now. If they can hang a little bit longer, then we'll do that. I mean, there's a lot of reinforcement that I want to do. Bottom A-arm, the belly, all kinds of stuff. There's always upgrades to do on these cars, on these lowriders. All right, from looking at that video, it doesn't look that bad. It does look like the frame is splitting a little bit, but that's like the split that these G-bodies have on top. I do want to weld that up. I mean, I'm not going to go really hard on the car. I'm not going to upgrade the coils until, like I said, until I reinforce a lot more things. And then we're going to go with some 3.5 tons. Like I said, I don't know what size these are. I know I have, what, like 4.5 turns on these coils. We'll take a look at them right now. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to lift the arm. I'm going to lift it and put it back on the ball joint. Come on, go in the hole. There we go. I'm just going to put a couple of threads on the nut, put it back on. And there it is, let it hang. So here they are side by side. I have passenger side on this side, driver side on this side. As you can tell, the cup is cut. I'm not sure why it was placed that way, and it has a bead of weld in there to hold it together, I guess. And then I do have, let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 donuts on the top on both of them. I do want to take apart this one. I just want to see what it looks like on the inside and what kind of O-rings I need. The coils, I place them the same way that they came out because I am going to put them back in this in the same direction that they came out. Take this one off first. This is a 19 millimeter. Put this off to the side. Take off the donut or the cup. So you can see the weld that they put right there. Stitch weld it. See, this one's already coming off. Put this off to the side. Take off these donuts one at a time. All that oil coming out of there. I'm gonna take off this right here. On this one, it's plastic. I've seen some that are copper or it's a brass. Put that off to the side. Let's see where we're at. You see all that buildup right there. That nastiness. See that? And just like that, I just came back from Hoppo's. Went ahead and got some brand new 8-inch cylinders. I did buy the O-rings for the old ones. I do want to rebuild those anyways. And I did buy the fittings that go on the cylinders here. And then one thing I wanted to show you is check that out. See that yellow piece right there? That's that brass sleeve I was talking about. Mine is plastic. I did end up taking this cylinder here, the old one, so we could take it apart over there and look at the O-rings, see which ones I needed. Vic was the one that was helping me out over there. Real nice guy, answered all my questions. I did start getting carried away because I showed him pictures of this and I told him I wanted to get some new ones, but then I started reminding myself that I'm only replacing the cylinders because I don't want it to leak anymore. I mean, in the future, I do want to upgrade my whole front suspension. I mean, the whole system, I want to upgrade it. I also took measurements of my coils here, of how thick the coil actually is. I measured it with the tape measure, and I showed him a picture of it. I told him it was about a 15/16 to an inch thick coil. So he did pull out a 2-ton pre-cut and measured it. And I told him, yeah, it measures pretty much the same. So these, in my opinion, are 2-ton. So that's what I have. I never knew what I had, so now I know. I already put everything back together on the driver's side. I put the new cylinder, the new ball joint. I did try to clean up the coil and the cup on the driver's side. As you can see right here, I used some of this engine degreaser. I made a mess on all over my floor, and then I ended up deciding, you know what, I'm gonna put everything back together just like that. So these, I'm just gonna give them a quick wipe and then put them back in. And then another thing was that I did take a picture of this and showed it to Vic over there, and I told him, look, I don't know why this is cut like that. And he said, it's not cut, they welded, it looks like they used a small cup and then they welded a pipe to it. And I was like, I don't think so. So after cleaning up the driver's side, that's exactly what they did. That groove right there goes all the way around. So, I mean, it is what it is. 16 or 17 years later, I realized that they did this. It worked this whole time, so whatever. So I'll try to clean this one up a little bit so I can show you that all the way around. And then I'm going to show you how I put everything together on the other one. Let's go. Take off the cap. Put some Loctite on there. There's that brass bushing I was telling you guys about. A lot better. I'm using this Loctite 545. This is what Alex and Vic recommended to use. Throw a little bit of this on there, all the way around. Pop this back on. And they told me to hit it with a pipe wrench real quick, just a slight snug, so that way it doesn't come off. Because as you saw on the other ones, it was already loose, the cap was already loose, so he told me to, he recommended some Loctite on here. So let me do that. All right, so now with that done, let's put these donuts on. Already took them off of the other one. Put it back. See if we can even. I'm gonna have to do it one by one. Keep hitting the camera, sorry. Alright, so now that's that. And then let me show you before I put this on. I'm not gonna put this on just yet, but I did give it a wipe down. Let me see. So you see that seam right there? All the way around. All the way around. Nasty. They just put 3 welds in there. Stitch welded it. Left all the burrs right here. So that's why I didn't even clean in there all that great, because they have all these burrs here. I don't want to cut myself. It's not even an even cut, look. All busted. It is what it is. And now it's time to put on the fitting. So let's put this fitting on. Take off the little cap here. Then I'm going to put Loctite on this too. Put a little bit of Loctite on here all the way around. Come on. think I'm putting too much on the cap on the cylinder. I think I put too much on there all the way around. I'm gonna use my baby little vise here, which is a Harbor Freight one. I already broke it. I'm gonna hit it from right here. I hate scratching these cylinders, but you gotta do what you gotta do. I'm sure there's a better way to do this. I should have researched it, but put it on there nice and tight. I don't want any leaks. I see how my vise is all busted. I really need to invest in a better vise. It's really getting me mad. Ready to go. Now we can put on the bottom piece here, tying that up. All right, let's pop this one in. This dirty ass cup. Put the bolt back in. I'm already cutting my gloves. See, the thing with these, you can't really tighten them all the way because then the shaft in there moves. So I'm not even sure exactly how they tighten these up normally. I don't know if they just kind of crank it. It does have a lock washer in there, so hopefully that keeps it on there. And there it is, ready to be put back on. Let's go put it on. So before I put on the cylinder and the coil back in there, I wanted to show you, I am going to replace the ball joint first before I put those in. So this is the driver's side. So these are the new ones that I bought. I'm going to put a link in the description. I'm going to show you guys where I got these from. But according to the research that I did, these are really good for this application. These aren't normally stock ball joints. These are supposedly some of the ones that I was recommended on Lay It Low, the forums over there. But look at this. See the sleeve on here? It's a lot bigger than this one. So we'll see how these work out. They're the same length. This one just has the nut sticking out a little bit higher, but they're pretty much the same length. Look at that. Check it out. So let's pop it in. We'll find out. There was nothing wrong with these as in functionality, but look at the boots on these. These are all busted. No grease in there. So I'm already here, so that's why I wanted to replace them. So let's get to that. Now with the arm supported, let's take off the nut over here again. Take this one off. So when I rebuild when I reinforce the bottom A arm, I do want to replace that ball joint too. Start taking this one off, 7/16. See how bad these are. Pop off the front ones first so I get room for the ones in the back. I really want to redo these upper A arms too. Looking at all the welds that they laid on here, really cold welds. I don't know if they laid really cold welds to prevent warping or what, but I don't like the way that they welded it. Their starts and stops are really busted. There's porosity here and there. On the back over here, same thing. A lot of inconsistencies in the weld. Look at me bringing in my work life into YouTube. So compressed that makes it hard to take it out. See how compressed it is? All busted. See, this one's ripped too. This one was a little bit better shape than the other one. This one's not that bad how dirty it is. The other one, the driver's side, was a lot dirtier. One at a time. Alright, so that's all tightened up. Put the little grease fitting over here. Socket size on this one is an 8mm. Now I'm gonna put it on too tight. I want to break that off in there. Now we can put the coil in and the new cylinder. Let's go. Pop it in through the front. Gotta see where that hole's at. And that's where the hole's at. So now time for the coil. It's always difficult with the camera there because I don't want to get in the way of the camera. Let that sit there for a little bit. So what I'm doing is I'm looking at the marks on the bottom A arm to see where this one was sitting at before. So that way it doesn't have to find its home after I hit the switch a couple times. So it looks like it's on this side. So I just got to lift it, pop it in there. having an assistant will be very nice. Let's get the coil started there. We could pop it. Let it find its home right there. And that's exactly where it needs to go. Look how dirty all that is. It is what it is. Now let's pop in the ball joint. Give it a couple hits. Like I said, good thing I don't have chrome A-arms. Put the nut. Tighten that up real nice. Then put in the cotter pin. And then we'll go up top. Let's go. Alright. Now let's take off this little cap. I did rotate the cylinder to the front. That's pretty much where I want it. Throw this back in there. I think we're good there. Hopefully I didn't over tighten it. Let's put the rims back on. Alright, so I already put the wheels back on. It's ready to be tested. But before that, I am going to add some oil over here. I'm going to use some of the cheapest oil I could find, O'Reilly's 10W30. I'm going to go ahead and put some in there, fill it up. Let's throw some in there. The way that I check it is I put my pinky in there. As long as my pinky gets wet with that oil, that's enough oil for me. That's the way I do it. I don't know if anybody else does it that way, but that's how I do it. And then don't tighten this up, just leave it kind of loose on there so that tank could breathe. Plug in the ground. Oh, let's give it a first shot. Let's see what's going on here. Cycle it. I want to check if it's leaking. Hopefully none of the lines over here are leaking. It's a little bit of oil from when I was putting it on. I don't know. Let me see. I'm going to leave it on there for a little bit. I'm going to grab a paper towel and check them and clean them from the residue that I left and then see if it leaks. I'm going to leave it locked up like this. We'll check all under there. But it looks like everything's pretty solid. It's ready to go. All that's left is to grease up my ball joints, which I'm going to do. But it looks like it's ready to go. Let's go. Thank you for watching.